If a person voluntarily leaves their job to move to another state, voluntarily goes back to college, really should they be eligible for unemployment comp benefits? And this clarifies the voluntary quit part. The only exception is we did modify the language for cases of domestic violence and made it very clear that a person that is a victim of domestic violence may leave their job voluntarily if they feel that's necessary and collect unemployment benefits. And we made it pretty easy to prove that because of the people that can attest to that, such as a clergyman, a counselor, somebody like that. The other part was the willful misconduct part, and what we basically did is inserted a new section of things that people might do that would just make them ineligible to collect unemployment benefits. And everybody believes that if somebody's violent in the workplace, steals from the employer, they really shouldn't be eligible for unemployment benefits. Representative Grove has a bill that addresses fraud in the unemployment comp system, increases penalties for those that commit intentional fraud against the system. It's possible somebody could collect unemployment when they're not eligible. They apply until the paperwork gets processed. This doesn't deal with that. This basically extends the time frame. If you willfully commit fraud against the system, there will be no statute of limitations on collecting the money. And it also addresses an issue that has been a news story for several TV stations recently on people that are incarcerated in prison collecting unemployment comp benefits. The key part here is that's illegal now, but this increases the penalties. And I want the public to know that in conversations with the Secretary of Labor and Industry, the department is trying to monitor that very closely. It's something they can cross-reference databases between the unemployment comp system and the prison system if it's a state prison. We have issues with cross-reference when you get to the county prison system, and they're working on fixing those. Everybody should know that those that are deserving of unemployment comp benefits can get them, and those that do not, we will, if they cheat the system, they will be prosecuted. We owe the federal government $3.5 billion, and it's growing. Basically, we are insolvent. We borrow the money to pay the unemployment comp claims. We certainly want people that deserve, that have lost their job through no fault of their own, to get their benefits. But we need to make sure that we are not wasting money in the system, and we limit it to only those that are truly deserving of getting those benefits.